I am so impressed. This is like every headshot we do from here on out. Like, I'm going to be applying this to it.
Hey everyone, welcome back. I've got a new AI resource today that will help you edit your photos in about 20 seconds instead of 20 minutes. And I just want to remind you that AI isn't out to replace photographers. It's meant to aid photographers, speed up our workflow. So until they have some AI robot that follows us around and directs our clients to take pictures, we're pretty safe. And full disclosure right up front, Retouch for Me did reach out and say, hey, we'd like to offer you 3 free plugins in exchange for a review video and to share your impressions with your audience. They did gift me the 3 plugins I will talk about today, but these thoughts and opinions are my own and there was no exchange of money. They did give me a 20% off coupon code to share with you guys, and I'll put that up on the screen now. It'll also be linked down in the description below. And they wanted me to mention that it can also be stacked on top of any promotions that they happen to be running on their website. We are on Retouch for Me's website and free trial for 20 photos right now. Specifically, we're going to look at Dodge&Burn, which takes quite a bit of time if you ever Dodge&Burn portrait photos yourself. We're going to be looking at the heel tool, which is down here. I'll show that off in a little bit. And then finally, we'll close out with portrait volumes. And portrait volumes is really cool. Like, it's a very unique feature. And I'll explain that when we get into it later. You can run all of these filters at one time after you install the plugin, or you could run them out of the app that they provide for you. Personally, I'm going to be looking at them in Photoshop because my whole editing process is finish editing all of the photos and then do the final polishing touches. I've already downloaded and installed all of the plugins into Photoshop, and what I'm going to do is continue to use it that way because I already do all of my edits here in Lightroom, except for like the healing stuff and clone stamping, Dodge&Burn, any sort of AI tool that I want to use, I kind of leave that for the end. And I do all of my basic edits, all of my cropping. I do some touch-ups, not much. Any vignettes we're going to add or color grading, I do that up front. And I save all the polishing for the very end. By the way, if you like some of my color grading and things like that, I have my presets for sale in the description of this video. So we're going to use this photo right here, the senior portrait session that we did recently, as an example, because we've gotten all of the edits up to that point of like those fine polishing retouches. So what I'm going to do now is take this photo and edit it over in the Photoshop by right-clicking, edit in Adobe Photoshop, and that should open up Photoshop for us. We're in Photoshop now. I've opened up the Retouch for Me panel, and we've zoomed in here, and you can see there's a few blemishes that we want to cover up. Now, normally, if you were in here or if you're in Lightroom, you'd use your clone stamp or your heel tool and you'd do little taps here and there to tap over these little things and hide them, right? That takes a few minutes, especially if you have somebody who's like currently having a breakout. Heel tool works great, but it takes time. So we've already gotten installed all of this here, and I'm going to run this preset right here. And it should take a few seconds. I'm going to time it real quick to heal, and that was on device, and so that was pretty quick. I don't know how it's going to work if you have an older device or something with less memory. You can also opt to do the cloud retouch version. That's a credit-based system, though. As you can see, this is pretty great. It brought up heal as a new layer, right? So it's non-destructive. So if you don't like it, you can delete it. Two things that I found myself doing. One is sometimes if somebody has a lot of freckles, like my man right here, I just back it off a little bit. Right, and we could see those freckles coming into play, but it doesn't like eliminate them. Okay, the other thing that we can do is like see some of these, like it got rid of some moles. Anything permanent on people's skin, I generally don't remove unless they ask me to. So what we can do here is grab our eraser tool and make sure I'm gonna actually turn the hardness all the way down so we can feather it in just a little bit better there. 35 is fine, and I want this mole back, a few moles back on the face here, because those are permanent, right? So we just add that back in by erasing it. Boom, there's one right here. Awesome. You can even see like it got rid of like a few little stray white whiskers here. That's crazy. So good. It did a pretty good job. Over here, one of these is a mole, one of them is not. So let's add back in some of these, okay, right? So let's add that one back in. Let's turn this off on back again. I know this dude. I know that those are permanent fixtures right there. Boom. And then, like I said, if we want to add some of those, like,
sunspots back in, those freckles, we can. That has saved us quite a bit of time, right? Imagine having to go in there and do that all yourself. So let's turn the opacity back up, and we'll say that this is a good place to finish. All right, so we've opened a new photo here with a portrait headshot that we did for a client recently. So let's go ahead, turn on heal, and run that and see what happens. So what's really cool is we can actually like hide the background too, I just realized, and see all of these little like complexion spots here that it put on. Pretty cool. So let's see the after, before. That's crazy. This client didn't want them removed, but just really wanted her complexion cleaned up. So what we can do here is just like drop the opacity to maybe like 35. Okay, so we don't have to go super aggressive with the healing. So here's the before and after. And it really just kind of like cleans up the complexion. Now I want to run Dodge&Burn to see what happens. Because I would Dodge&Burn some of the stuff around her eyes to really make them pop. And we're going to run Dodge&Burn. And let's see how this works. Because this person is an actress and we want her to have some great headshots to put in. And oh my goodness. That did such a great job. Like, it's subtle, but like, think about how much time that would have taken me. That's crazy. Whoa, it really does just like, wow. It probably does a better job than like I would have done if I poured over this by hand. Wow. Everything just looks a little bit more like refined. Wow. And it still retains. So here's the thing with the heel. Is it's still retaining the pores and textures of the skin, you know? Just eliminating some tiny parts of, like, the imperfections. And we're going to add some back in, like I said. We can always dial it back if we need to. We're going to save this as a photo that we can come back to and edit. But wow. And now, portrait volumes, I tested this a little bit, and this is the one that I said is crazy. Okay, I could tell stuff changed, but what really... Oh, wow. Oh my gosh. That is. Okay, so it's gone in and it's at. It's like a super. It's like, okay, here's Dodge&Burn. But this is like. See, so we turn off all the other layers. I think what's going on here. So there's this thing when you're working in three-dimensional spaces where you can have like depth mapping. And I think what this is doing is like. The AI is creating an artificial depth match because it's not a 3D image, right? We don't actually have the depth on it. And this Dodge&Burn is like, I think, running split frequency in the background. Yeah, and then the heel is like just generating the skin tone blends and gradients that will match it. So that's pretty cool. So if we turn all of these on, I think that's what's happening here. Okay, yeah. It's like adding contouring, but without makeup or anything like that. And it, like, it's... Okay, what's also really cool is, like, look where the lighting is naturally on some of these. So it's creating the depth in, like, hey, where there's things, like, protruding, like the nose, and recessed, like the eyes. But it's also catching, and it knows the direction of the lighting. So, like, our key light was coming down this direction a little bit at the face. And it's matching that. Like, it knows. Like, it's not putting the shadows the wrong direction. Like, if the shadows were the wrong direction, it would feel... It would, like, be visually jarring, and we'd be like, hey, something's uncanny about that. Lighting is something that, like, really tricks our brain into buying an illusion. And this is, like, wow. I am so impressed. This is, like, every headshot we do from here on out, like, I'm going to be applying this to it. I'm not going to do this for everything in the series, but I think the ones where our clients are like, these are my five favorites, or, you know, I am getting these printed if it's a wedding, or, like, they're going to get this. And I, oh my gosh, I'm having, like, my brain's like going, like, a million miles a minute right now, because I could also see myself saying, like, hey, record this action, turn these three on, run them all, and then... applying that to like 20 photos and coming back when that action has been run in Photoshop and then coming in and being like, oh yeah, you know what, maybe it went a little bit too overboard with some of the heel stuff, and I want to, you know, come back in here and maybe she, you know, we don't want to lose the freckle on the cheek here, so let's bring that in a little bit more fully, like that, and this one here and this one here, right? But everything else is fine. Wow, this is amazing. I love this. And we still haven't even retouched the hair yet. All right, so here is another portrait that we did of a branding client for a while back, and I just wanted to see how this will go if I run all three of them at the same time. So I'm going to hit retouch, and I'm going to have my heel, Dodge&Burn, and portrait volumes checked. Oh, and they're popping in. I think the heel just popped in. So to Dodge&Burn. And now, portrait volumes. So look, that took like 20 seconds. And so now I haven't really even looked at the image yet. I'm just going to make a new group here real quick and just going to put edits on here. And then I can close that down and we can see everything before and after. If I just do this. So now they're off and now I'm going to look at it. So it's off. Wow. Okay, look at the eyes when I do this. Boom. And the chin. It really defines the chin in a way that, like, I wouldn't have been able to, like, spend the time to make it that natural in, like, less than, like, 20 minutes focusing on this photo. That's crazy. I got rid of some of the blemishes there on the skin. Like I said, it can be a little bit heavy-handed, as we saw earlier, so with the heel. But that's fine. I'd rather it be heavy-handed and me be able to edit it out. So I turned the opacity down. You could do that, like I said before. So I'm going to put it at about 43%. And we still preserve some of those freckles and some of the moles and things like that. Yeah, the eyes pop. Was that Dodge&Burn? No. Or heel? No. That's the contouring is even, it's even affecting the eyes in a way that helps the eyes look more round. That's so good, cool. And it's just helping give a little bit more drama, but it's subtle. But a lot of times those subtle edits are like the biggest deals. That's so good. I haven't tested it to see how it does multiple subjects. So let's run all three on here again. We'll zoom in once it's done running. Okay, so it's taking just a tiny bit longer to do three people than it does just one subject, but that's fine because it's still faster than what I would do. Okay, so let's zoom in here. Check out these three kiddos. Let's turn portrait volumes and Dodge&Burn and heel. All right, so let's check out the heel. Okay, so you can see, like, there's a scar up here that it's getting rid of. Some sun blotches on the nose, like you could tell here where there was like some peeling from a scab that had fallen off. So that's pretty good. But again, I don't want it to get rid of those moles. So that's my only complaint. It's great for beauty editing, but like, yeah, let's add some of that back in. So it does do a good job. It doesn't eliminate any scars and moles, but it just makes them a little bit less pronounced. So I think I'm gonna go by leaving the heel about 50. Dodge&Burn, zoom out so we just get their faces a little bit big and in the center here. Okay, cool. So deselect that real quick. And Dodge&Burn, actually I kind of like it before the Dodge&Burn, because the Dodge&Burn kind of like flattens out their face. A lot of times we're adding Dodge&Burn around the eyes and things like that. I don't know. I think for a group of boys, it looks a little bit too polished for my liking. What about portrait volume? Oh, so portrait volume actually like adds more contour. So what happens if we have both of them on? So this is both Dodge&Burn and portrait volumes. This is just portrait volumes. And I really like it with just the portrait volumes. The Dodge&Burn, I could take it or leave it. Wow. Just like, it just makes it look, I don't know. Like, this is how you, when you remember people in your head, like, this is how, like, you remember them. You don't remember all of their blemishes. You remember their best features. And this is really highlighting and exaggerating their best features, like the parts of the faces. I mean, like, it's doing such a good job with three of them, too. And so imagine, like, you know, dodging and burning and healing for, like, one portrait. But, like, when you have multiples, when, like, there are three, four, five, six people in a portrait and you have to do it, this is handling it so well. Like, we have a wedding to shoot in a week or two, and I'm already, like, thinking about, like, hey, I'm going to be running this on the finals that our clients choose from the wedding as their favorites, right? And the ones that we deliver for printing for them, like, this is going to get that retouching. Because, like, it's like you're not losing even any of, like, the natural grain. Like, it retains that noise patterning that's kind of, like, built into my camera. So it doesn't look artificial or fake or anything. This is, okay. I don't know what to say. To be honest, I wasn't, like, expecting it to blow me away this much. It's specifically the portrait volumes. That's the one that, like, if I'm going to spend my money on it, like, this is the one, right? And the clothes, I forgot. It's doing it to those. But what does it do to, like, the extremities and the fingers? All right. It's actually, it knows the pants and the even, like, the toes. I don't know what to say. This is, like, like I said before, I'm just, like, thinking about all the things this could do if you, like, can plug in some Photoshop actions on this for, like, a whole suite of photos. And it's like, hey, there are 50 of these that all need these, and you just run this as an action, and it, boom. Like I said before, these are my own opinions, and there was no exchange of money between me and Retouch for me. Like I said, they just gave me 3 credits to be able to try their software. So we have to answer the question now. Would I recommend this? Like, what do we think? And I want to hear from you in the comments. So let me know. Hit subscribe if you want to see more content like this. But I want to know, which one of these three would you spend your money on? Let's say if you could only pick one. And so for me, if I could only pick one, because I know that this software is a little bit on the more expensive side, however, it seems pretty quality, I would have to say portrait volumes. That one stood out as definitely worth the money. It did the most amount of stuff in a very quick and short amount of time in a way that's actually pretty difficult to replicate. There's a lot of contour and shading, and I could see how that, like, if you have a Wacom tablet or if you're editing on your iPad, that just shading some of those things going back and forth would take quite a bit of time. So that kind of contouring thing, that's such a unique feature. I would definitely put out the money for that. That being said, the heel was okay. It got rid of a few things that I didn't want to get rid of. Easier than clicking on everything you want to delete. And it does a good job in that it selects a lot of stuff and doesn't get rid of freckles. Sometimes it gets rid of some moles and things like that. But I would rather delete a few things from a mask as opposed to, like, having to spend more time, like, selecting and reselecting if it doesn't get it right the first time. So I'd say that would be my second in priority. And the Dodge&Burn, honestly, I would say let's leave it. I would probably spend my money on something different that they have to offer. Like, one thing that I was looking around on their website was the mattifier. And for me, that would be a huge, huge value add. So that's actually something I may actually use our own discount and purchase that one, because I'm very frequently trying to edit specular highlights on skin. And like I said, I would recommend portrait volumes if you're not going to check anything else out. At least go download the free trial and give it a shot and see if it would be beneficial for you and your workflow. So overall, I want to know what your opinion on that was. And I know I didn't get a chance to, like, go super crazy in depth, but I will be using them from here on out on a lot of my edits and those kinds of things. So if you're more interested in this kind of, like, AI tools and photo editing and, like, advice for developing your skills as a photographer, give us a like, a comment, a subscribe, you know, the standard YouTube transactions if you find something valuable.